This video is to help you understand your worksheet for tonight, your homework. So this is practicing putting everything together that we've done the last few days with percents and fractions and decimals. So you have a table here. You're given sometimes two things, but mostly one of the two things, one of the three things, and you need to figure out how to represent that number in the other forms that are missing. If you notice on the front side of the worksheet here, I put some nice helpful hints, reminders here of how you go back and forth, all the different ways you might need to do it. So fraction to decimal, decimal to percent, percent to decimal, decimal to fraction, percent to fraction, fraction to percent. Those are all the possibilities. So this is like shorthand reminder of what I'm about to show you right here. So take a look at A. I showed you originally what this fraction would be if you were like using it from a decimal or a percent first. So if you had like the decimal 0.15, you know that's 15 hundredths. So you would start writing it out as 15 hundredths, but it would reduce to 3/20, right? So make sure that all these fractions that you put them in simplest form, reduced form, okay? So we can see these are all equivalent. 3/20, which is the same as 15 hundredths, is the same as 15 hundredths as a decimal, which is the same as 15%. So take a look at B. You have the fraction is 73 hundredths. That is reduced. There's no number that divides into 73 and 100 and 73%. You need to make that a decimal. Well, when you've got two different pieces of information, you've got a choice here to go from fraction to decimal. Remember, fractions just mean division. So you are allowed to use a calculator on this worksheet. So you could do 73 divided by 100 in your calculator, and that would tell you what it is as a decimal. But it might be just as easy, if not easier and faster, to use the percent. And remember, we can use drop to go back and forth between percents and decimals. We have a percent, we want to make it a decimal, so we should move the decimal, which is currently at the end of the number here, back two spots. So your decimal, whether you do 73 divided by 100 or use drop, you should get 0.73, 73 hundredths. Take a look at C. You've got 39%. You need to come up with the decimal and come up with the fraction. I would start first. Really, either of these aren't going to be too bad when you're given the percent. If we go percent to get the decimal, again, you can just use drop, just like we did up here. The decimal's back here behind the 9, so move it 2 to the left. So we're going to get 39 hundredths. And then think about percents are out of 100. So to write a percent as a fraction, and we did that earlier this week, that means you take that number that's the percent, that's your numerator, and your denominator is 100 always. You would reduce if you can, but 39 one-hundredths can't be reduced. The next one there, that's kind of blurry on the sheet there, isn't it? That is 1/25. Now, you guys hopefully have the sheet in front of you so you can tell, but I know the video, it's going to look a little blurry. So that's obviously a reduced fraction. It's not out of 100 right now. So if I want to make that a percent, if I'm trying to go from fraction to percent, remember, the way you do that is make it a fraction out of 100. Think about what did I multiply by to get from 25 to 100? I multiplied by 4, so 1 times 4 is 4. So that means it's 4%. To get what that is as a decimal, I can either do 4 divided by 100, 1 divided by 25, or I can take my percent and use drop. Or you can think about the way it's written here. 4/100. Think about place value. This is the tens place. This is the hundredths place. So it's 4 in the hundredths place. All right, your next example, E, you've got 77/100. This is probably the one that kids struggle with the most, is how do I make that decimal and write it as a fraction? And my hint to you, which I said down here, I said use place value, and the other thing I usually say to students is say it the right way. So instead of saying 0.77, say it using place value. Say it as 77/100, because it's in the tenths hundredths spot. Remember, when you're in class, you can look back at that poster on my back wall, and that will help you remember your place value. So if it's 77/100, then you basically just said what it is as a fraction. It's 77/100. Okay, so you're done. That's it as a fraction. Now to make that a percent, that's easy. Use drop. So remember, when you have a decimal going to percent, you're moving 2 to the right with the decimal. So that would mean it's 77%. Your next example there is 46%. So 46% as a decimal, use drop, you're going to go backwards. That's 0.46. Say that the right way. That's 46/100. So that means your fraction is 46/100. This one, though, you can reduce. So think about what you could reduce by. You can divide those both by 2. That would be 23/50 when you reduce. All right, they get a little more challenging now. These first few ones were kind of easy. Now we're getting into the challenging ones. You're going to have some challenging ones on the back, too, for your homework. How would we say this the correct way? It goes 3 numbers past the decimal. So this is the tenths, hundredths, thousandths place. So this is 52 thousandths. So to write that as a fraction, that's 52 over 1,000. I know reducing is a challenge for some of us, but remember, look at those last numbers and think about your divisibility rules. I know it can at least divide by 2, so you could start with that. If you divide by 2, you're going to get 26 over 500, but look at those last numbers. They're still even, so I can divide by 2 again, and I'm going to get 13 over 250. I'm trying to make my pen a little smaller here. There we go. To make this a percent, that should be pretty easy. Oh, that's still like the same size. Use drops, so go 2 to the right, and that's 5.2%. 6 1/10. We haven't had any examples yet that were over 100%, right? But this is going to be because it's a mixed number as a fraction. So 6 1/10, what would that be as a decimal? Well, if I say it the fraction way, think about saying it in place value. 6 1/10. So 6.1. 6 1/10. It's in the tenths place. You can also divide. 1 divided by 10 would give you 0.1, and then you know you need to have a 6 in front of that. To make that a percent, go 2 to the right. Fill in that empty spot with a 0, so that's 610%. Here we have a percent over 100, but we're starting with the percent, 280%. If you use drop, start back here at the end of the number. Move back twice. So as a decimal, that's 2.8, or if we say it the right way to figure it out as a fraction, 2 8/10. So 2 8/10 can be reduced. Think about what number you can divide into both 8 and 10. That would be 2. So we're going to get 2 4/5. All right, and last example on the example side, you have 13/50, that is. So that's obviously been reduced because some of these start out at 100, right? So to figure out what that is as a decimal, you can divide 13 divided by 50. You can also figure out what it is as a percent, and then go to decimal. So 50 times 2 is 100, so 13 times 2 is 26. So that means it's 26%. And then if I move back twice, that means my decimal answer is 26/100. All right, so you guys are responsible for doing the other side. Same thing, just different number examples, okay? So if you get stuck, maybe rewatch some of these examples. Look at these helpful hints at the bottom. When you're done with your homework, hang on to it. We will grade it on Monday. You may read. You may work on other homework. You may practice division flashcards quietly. I would suggest doing division since that's the time test that we're worried about right now.